Older New Zealanders deserve to enjoy their retirement. They deserve to know they are being taken care of and the financial support they rely on will be there for them despite the difficult global economic conditions we've faced as a country. Which is why early on I made a promise to all New Zealanders that the rate of superannuation will remain at 66% of the average wage for a married couple. This is only fair. Unlike some others, I won't use superannuation as a political football, creating unnecessary uncertainty for older New Zealanders who do not deserve such games. And despite the difficult financial times in the past 5 years under National, the rate of super has increased by 25%. This is much higher than the rate of inflation over the same period. A married couple now receives $1,099 a fortnight in superannuation payments. This financial certainty is what I want for all New Zealanders aged over 65. Which is why I've also committed to maintaining the age you can start receiving New Zealand Super at 65 years of age. Some out there may tell you this is costing New Zealand too much. When you go away and look at the numbers, you'll actually see quite a different story. New Zealand only spends about 4.6% of our GDP on super payments, which is extremely low by OECD standards. If you compare this with France, which currently spends 12.5% of GDP on old age benefits, or Germany, which spends 10.7% of GDP supporting their older populations. My commitment to giving older New Zealanders the financial security they deserve is another reason why the National-led government won't stoop to raiding the savings older New Zealanders have built up over their lifetime of working hard to fund policy promises that can't be fulfilled. This is about fairness for those who've worked hard for a lifetime and deserve it most. Another issue which I know concerns many older New Zealanders is the physical security they feel at home and in their communities. I can assure you National is committed to cracking down on crime. We've boosted the police force by 600 officers and we've overseen the lowest crime rate in 30 years. But we aren't finished yet. We've got a strong plan in place to sharpen up our bail and parole laws. We've already implemented the three strikes law to keep the very worst offenders behind bars. And we're restoring the needs of victims to the heart of our justice system, which is where they belong. As Prime Minister, I meet with many older New Zealanders across the country. I'm constantly inspired by their stories and by the things they have achieved, as well as the sacrifices they've made to help their families succeed. It is for this reason that I'm absolutely committed to supporting them in their retirement.